Slow poker.
I have a career and a family, but also play poker, which doesn't leave me much time, so let's get to it. Yes, last time I did promise more of the usual slow poker fare, and that is en route. But hold on to your butts, because today I bring you a very special episode involving $30,000 and disturbing violations of privacy. But first, context. The good people at Poker.org crafted this high-stakes challenge.
Who am I? That's for you to find out. I'll be traveling from town to town, playing poker across America. And if you find me, you win this. And if not, it's all mine. So don't try too hard. The name's Runner Runner, and maybe I'll see you soon. But hopefully not.
Spoiler alert, that shadowy figure? Your boy Slow. Those blinds? My blinds. Poker.org asked me to be a super secret poker fugitive, covertly playing cards in 10 different casinos across America for 3 weeks, all while avoiding capture from relentless bounty hunters. The stakes? This highly coveted $30,000 platinum pass, granting entry to the Poker Stars Players Championship 25K main event, a tournament in the Bahamas with a hefty 8-figure prize pool, plus a free vacation and VIP access to a sick water slide. As of November 28th, all of that is mine. But if at any point over 3 weeks, a bounty hunter tracks me down and asks me the secret passphrase, "How do you feel about rabbit hunting?" they get my 30K platinum pass, and I get nothing. Okay, game on. Let's do this. Well, before doing this, let's do this.
What's this for?
For love. Also, can you watch the kids for 3 weeks while I play poker across America? That's my flight. I gotta go. I love you.
After flying to my first secret location, since I'm required on each travel day to show footage of myself for at least 5 seconds outside a public place of business, here's what I post.
After an exhausting first day of travel, at long last I've reached the great state of... You didn't think I'd make it that easy for you. Wherever I am, next up on the agenda? The Felt. I'll see you there. Hopefully you won't see me.
Not too revealing, right? That's what I thought. We're both wrong. In less than 1 hour, multiple bounty hunters track down the exact address of that gas station. And one bounty hunter, let's call him Cat Tax Plan, drives to the gas station and convinces the manager to give him the security footage.
I've been on the grind, ladies and gentlemen. I'm hunting him down. I'm a bounty hunter.
Are you a manager by any chance, or someone that I could talk to about maybe getting some surveillance footage?
We found him. Oh my God, this is the guy coming into the pump. Who is that?
And yes, we can all agree this is equal parts impressive and horrifying as f***. More on this later, but for now, know that I'm handed the ultimate lifeline, because Tax Cat Plan might be so hell-bent on winning this thing solo that he keeps this intel mostly to himself instead of assembling a syndicate to quickly uncover my identity. If I have to stay hidden for 3 weeks despite a wanted sign, I'm toast. So right off the jump, I get extremely lucky, which means it's been 24 hours and I haven't lost.
I am the greatest.
By rule, I have to play at least 1 hour of poker every other day and post video proof. So here's that.
In my first session, I was dealt this hand, but also the best hand ever created. And I folded it pre-flop. So you can cross off one suspect. Before cashing out, I'll leave behind a clue for my new friend in seat 2. But the heat is on. Time to run. Maybe to somewhere with less heat.
Granted, this one's kind of a dead giveaway. As expected, mostly due to carpet, bounty hunters immediately pinpoint Seminole Casino, Coconut Creek. Given the first video already outed my South Florida position, my initial thinking is that it can't hurt to reveal the obvious if I'm already out the door. But I later realize this may come back to bite me. As for the seat 2 gift, that's one of my calling cards. At every stop, I leave several of these behind, at poker tables, at the cage, in restrooms, everywhere. The QR code prompts you to spread the word and leave a voicemail describing where you found the card and what I look like. This time, I leave one of the cards with a spry older gentleman who couldn't be prouder of his Israeli hair. Hey, look, that's me! Just after delivering my calling card, I sprint to the elevator, but there's a crowd waiting for it, and that's bad news for me, so I audible for the stairs. And good thing I don't dilly-dally, because I escape mere minutes before at least one bounty hunter bursts onto the scene. Another close call, but I'm still alive. But also still in Florida. Win-lose.
I may have given away too many details in my first two videos, because some of you almost caught me. So I'll have to be more careful. How's this for vague? I drink coffee in the morning. I'm at this independent coffee shop, which should narrow down my coordinates. I'm wearing gloves, either because it's cold here or because I want you to think it's cold here. And that's it for clues. You've all made me paranoid. I could've sworn I saw this barista yesterday at PLO. Time to get out of here, fast. See you at the next poker room, Yolanda. Thanks for the soy latte.
This video is intentionally light on details and fires out one huge misdirect in that I didn't buy a soy latte, but a black coffee. But as I hightail out of town, it quickly becomes clear that in fact I showed too much leg, and that as I lift my coffee cup, sharp-eyed bounty hunters notice the Snoopy sticker on this building next door, dig deeper, and yet again, home in on my exact coordinates. So after a several-hour stop at a library to wrap up and release the latest Slow Poker episode, I then find a costume shop, because by rule I can be in disguise, and I get the sense it'll be harder than expected to stay hidden. Also might as well post a few thirst traps. Since by now I've already tipped off everyone that I'm in Florida, where I'd planned on playing next, maybe in Daytona or Jacksonville, apparently bounty hunters have already set up shop at those poker rooms, waiting to pounce. So I follow the guidance of Florida's tourism slogan, and venture much further north, where my new plan is to play my second session at Harris Cherokee in North Carolina. That is, until while driving just outside Cherokee, listening to a podcast about me, I hear this.
I have a feeling that they're gonna want him to hit up, like, middle of nowhere spots.
Mm-hmm.
Like, I think this is good, like a middle of America type.
You mean Choctaw?
Yeah, who's the known person right now in Cherokee, North Carolina?
Yeah.
You know, it's quite the feeling, approaching a secret destination, only to hear that secret destination mentioned on a live podcast about you. Given this and some others guessing Cherokee, I decide to get some sleep, wake up early, demolish an avocado, and hit the road again. And hundreds of miles later, play my second poker session far further afield than anticipated. How much further afield? Oh, you'll see.
Back on the felt, with one eye on my cards and one eye over my shoulder. Cause it seems like more and more people know where I've been and where I'm going. But I can focus just enough to make a light hero call with pocket sixes, and run jacks into quads. That's great news for the lovely woman in the 8 seat. She can have my chips. And the high hand bonus, as long as I keep my platinum pass. After leaving behind a clue for everyone at table 1, I vanish into the night. Next stop? You tell me.
At least a few bounty hunters pick up on the three biggest clues, namely the chips, the felt, and the high hand bonus, and correctly ID Caesars Southern Indiana. Yeah, you heard right, Indiana. Due to nothing but, you know, abject fear. Between my first and second poker session, I drive 1,000 miles. Suffice it to say, this is not sustainable. That said, at least there's one moment that fools one person.
Honestly, yeah. The other clue in this is this guy immediately tells a bad beat.
Right.
Yeah. So it's like, this is certainly not like some high level, this guy's not emotionally all there, right?
Yeah.
Sounds like Matt Berkey got a read on me, picking up on a tell in my fake robot voice. That I was steamed about a bad beat. Hate to break it to you, Burke, but when that nice older lady rivered quads, IRL, I simply dapped her up. Cause big pot, high hand bonus, good for her. So it seems that someone's breaking up the wrong tree. Hey, that's enough. If I'm away from the kids for this long, I can't let my dad pun muscles atrophy. Gotta stay limber.
I've been driving more than anticipated. At one point, I was about to walk into my next card room, but noticed that one or more of these people guessed that I'd be at that exact spot. So I got back in my car and changed course. Yet some of you still seem to know exactly where I've been. So in this video, I'd like to throw you off the scent. On that note, some of this driving footage could be from today, but maybe not. And you probably expect me to play poker tomorrow. But you'd be wrong. I played today. And this time maybe you won't figure out where. No felt color clues this time. And here are some less specific features of this establishment. I played well, and was about to walk away with a nice win, but then it all disappeared when seat 1 outplayed me by 4-bet jamming kington offsuit and flopping 2 pair against my 3-bet big slick. Hopefully he catches me because he sure seems like PSBC final table material to me. But enough tilt. Time to hit the road. Please don't guess where I'm going, any of you. Because I'd prefer to drive less.
While this video is sparse on details, plenty guess Hard Rock Cincinnati, and yet again, spot on. But the real winners are the young students at the Xavier University Starbucks during my editing session.
In my effort to look inconspicuous, I think I just look like a creep.
And somehow I avoid capture from both bounty hunters and campus police.
I've tried to be careful, but some of you people are relentless. I won't say whether this tracking map is accurate, but its existence alone makes me sweat bullets. By the way, in January, don't forget this one. Not sure how long I can go undetected with so many of you closing in on me. It's gotten to the point that I'm looking for a loophole in the rules to avoid sitting at a table with 8 potential bounty hunters, and instead just play video poker. As for my current location? All I'll say is that it's rainy and windy outside this bookstore, and that's all you need to know. Runner, out.
First off, did I mistakenly not fully crop out my Google avatar? Is the runner Luckbox hero Ethan Rampage Yao? Or is this a clue? Because Ethan Rampage Yao is an anagram for Paraguay methane. And while Ethan and I were running it up together on last year's South American poker tour, we posted on Instagram that... No, it's not a clue. And there's no need to dance around the obvious bookstore head fake. Yes, of course, it's a Panera Bread, but it does seem like precious few bounty hunters used this brickwork to isolate my location. Still, a rare whiff by them doesn't mean I can let my guard down. In fact, given how many calling cards I've left in my wake, how many people can identify me? And since my route's been mapped out, can my likely next stop be extrapolated? Am I in trouble? The last thing I need is a close shave. And maybe this is irrational, but the best counter against a close shave could be a close shave?
So my plan is to wear some wigs in upcoming days, and so sideburns can't be poking out of the wigs, which means all of this is about to go. Sorry, wife. I'm gonna get caught in like 5 minutes.